The tool will come in different functionality levels. The hardware will be the same, but it will be three different levels. They're called digital, smart, and connected. So the digital version is our step-in version. It is to cover applications without the need to save any data, like maintenance applications, for example. The smart version is the main version for field applications where you don't want a controller, you still want to have the process control and document your work through data savings. Connected is where we connect the tool to a PF6000 controller and we'll run it like any tensor tool with all the benefits of live data feed and analysis for the full process control and traceability. Press and hold the middle button. Use the side buttons to flip through the menu. You want to hit tightening, confirm, set torque, and here you enter the desired torque level. One push is 5 Newton meter steps. If you press and hold, it's steps of 50. Once you reach the desired torque, you confirm, and you're good to do your tightening. If you want to loosen, you use the function button as a double click to go to reverse mode. This tool is now its own network. We made the tool into an access point and we placed a web server onto the tool, which means that the tool itself is a Wi-Fi network which you can connect to with any device with a Wi-Fi module, such as your phone, your laptop, a tablet, whatever. So you can log on to the tool in a couple of different ways. One way is that you find the Wi-Fi network, you log on, you enter the password, after that you open your web browser, enter the IP address, and then you're in. If you have an iPhone, the easiest way is to scan the QR codes on the tool. So what you do is, you go to information, you find there will be two QR codes. You scan the first one to join the network. You ask me if you want to join. Yes, we do. Flip and scan the second. Do you want to open it in Safari? Yes, we do. So once we've done that, we're now in the tool and now we can configure the PSETs, the batches, get results and do whatever we want to do. You will find a few different options once you log on to the tool. The main one, the basic one, will be for you the tightening programs. This is where you will find the PSETs. You can program up to 10 PSETs on one tool. As you can find when you enter there is that the interface has been a lot more simplified than compared to the PF6000. You basically need to give the PSET a name, a target torque, and a tolerance, and that's it. Then you can go out and make new PSETs. There's also an option for batches. And a batch is basically a PSET with a screw count, which means there will be a drop-down menu and you pick whichever PSET you want to use, add the number of bolts, save, and then go out again. There are some settings available and some tool information, but the first two will be the main ones to use. Okay, now we've done all the configuration. We created our PSETs, we created our batches, and now it's time to log out from the tool and now you head out into the field.